wrestling fans from Greenville, South Carolina's Memorial Auditorium. Welcome to another action-packed, exciting hour of Smoky Mountain Wrestling. Professional wrestling like it used to be and the way you like it. I'm Bob Caudle, and on this week's program, you're going to be seeing such outstanding stars as White Lightning, Tim Horner, Fantastics, Bobby Fulton is going to be here, as well as Primetime Brian Lee. And Mysterious Black Scorpion also is going to be here, fans. We'll be talking with two managers. We'll be talking with Ron Ward and also with Jim Cornette and with a commissioner, Smoky Mountain Commissioner Bob Armstrong. Our big main event, Bobby Fulton of the Fantastics against the Russian Bear, Ivan Koloff. And what a match that's going to be with. And here to help me call all the action, none other than the Dirty Dutchman himself, Dutch Mantell. Dutch?
Well, first of all, I'm here to see Ivan Koloff and Bobby Fulton lock horns in this ring right here today. And I'm wondering, they've been talking about this guy called Primetime Brian Lee. Well, I'm going to get my first look at him today, as will all you fans, and I'm just going to see what Brian Lee's got to offer here.
Fans, it's going to be a great hour. Stay with us. We're about ready for the action. Let's go to the ring.
Ladies and gentlemen, this first match is one fall with a 15-minute time limit. Gentlemen, in the ring now from Hell's Kitchen, New York, at 280 pounds, Killer Kyle and his opponent. From Pensacola, Florida, Rock and Roll, Robert Gibson.
All right, fans, our opening match here. Rock and Roll, Robert Gibson.
Now, Kyle is a big one, Dutch Mantell. All 280 pounds. And they call him Killer Kyle. That's the one that they go by. And they came in.
Be in that case.
Well, now I'm not Gene Dixon here. I don't know exactly what might be in that violin case, but I'm sure what's in it is his own personal business. And if you want to ask him, you go ahead, because I don't think I'm going to take the liberty of asking Killer Kyle what's in the violin case. If he wanted to tell me, I'm sure he would.
All the way across the ring. Off the ropes comes Kyle, and down goes Gibson from that block, and he got good power behind that one. Kyle from Hell's Kitchen, New York, and Dutchie's got a real reputation all around wrestling profession of being a real street fighter.
Well, he looks like a street fighter. You know, I'm a street fighter myself. So as one street fighter to the next, I'd hate to meet him in a dark alley. Now, Robert Gibson has met him in a real bad place. He's met him inside a wrestling ring. Now, Robert Gibson, everybody knows that he was a former NWA World's Tag Team Champion along with Ricky Morton. Now, four times. Not right. One, two, or three. Four times, and that means he was a pretty fair wrestler. Now, Killer Kyle, but when a man like Killer Kyle meets a man like Robert Gibson right here on Smoky Mountain Wrestling, He is out to make a name for himself, and what an excellent name he would make today if he could win a debut match against a man of Robert Gibson's stature.
Well, I don't think there's any doubt about that, but as you say, you don't become four-time world champion, tag team champion, along with your partner unless you got a tremendous amount on the ball. Right there, Kyle showed you some of that power and strength. He just stood there from that block by Gibson as Gibson came off the ropes. That time, he went to the head and right around the throat. He couldn't stand up under that pressure.
Yeah, but he couldn't hold him down for the count. He couldn't take him down. Now, he might knock him off his feet. I think what Robert Gibson may be doing right now, he may be getting just under Killer Kyle's skin just a little bit. And when you make a man like Killer Kyle mad, a man 280 pounds, there's no telling what could happen. Robert Gibson, as everybody knows, is coming off a knee injury. So his knee is questionable at best.
Well, he doesn't seem to be favoring it. He doesn't seem to be favoring it at all, as a matter of fact. And he put a lot of pressure on it. He said he had it out of his mind that he was going to go all out and not worry about the knee. But there you got a good example of the power of the big man, 280 pounds. So far, he's been able to muscle Gibson, get him over near the ropes and into the corner and handle him. That's what he does now, as again, he drove the knee up and down with the wrist. And down goes Gibson to his knees.
You know, I've often wondered, he was at one time the Rock and Roll Express. Why did they call them the Rock and Roll Express? Were they some kind of singers or something? What's the problem here?
Oh, yeah, I heard them one time with their rock and roll band. And, you know, fans still chant rock and roll in all of the arenas wherever they go to support Gibson. And not only that, he kicked out just a count of one. That sort of drives his opponents nuts when the fans get that rock and roll chant going.
Well, they released a record one time, and it went plywood within the first 3 weeks. It sold in excess of 75 copies, I think. And it was all on the verge of becoming sheetrock.
Kyle there with that arm across that rope, and he had it wrapped in that rope. He had, again, pressure on that, and Gibson felt the effects of that. Got a whip into the corner, reversal there by Killer Kyle. The big man showing his power. There's a neat move by Gibson.
Well, he went. Oh.
And he put the pin on it. Oh. 1, 2, 3.
And your winner, Rock and Roll Express, Robert Gibson.
Coming out of the corner, and Dutch, we can take another look at that in slow motion.
Well, I think Killer Kyle made a mistake. He didn't expect this move right here. He went in to give the shoulder. Robert Gibson raised the legs and barely hooked him, but he got him down and pulled him back. It surprised Kyle, but he got the win right here on Smoky Mountain Wrestling.
1, 2, 3 for Gibson and Fins right now. Let's hear from the Fantastics and about their main event match coming up later in this program.
It's a pleasure to be here in Smoky Mountain Wrestling, and today my brother's going to be in the main event.
You know, I want to tell you something, Ivan Koloff, the Russian Bear. We have traveled and battled far and wide across the United States, and right here on Smoky Mountain Wrestling, we're going to meet in the main event. That's right. Koloff, I feel that personally this could be the roughest, toughest match we've had yet. I know that the fans are excited about it. I'm fired up and excited about it. Koloff, I know you can get mean and nasty, brother, but let me tell you one thing right now. We have proved in the past we can take a licking and keep right on ticking. So, Russian Bear Koloff, be prepared for the fight of your life from Bobby Fulton.
Fans, earlier today we had a chance to talk to Smoky Mountain Commissioner, wrestling great Bob Armstrong. Bob Armstrong has a lot of ideas and a lot of thoughts about what's really going to make Smoky Mountain Wrestling great. We know you'd be interested in hearing that, so right now let's hear from Commissioner Bob Armstrong.
Fans, here's wrestling legend Bullet Bob Armstrong, now Commissioner of Smoky Mountain Wrestling. Bob, you bring over 30 years of experience to this job. What can we expect from you as Commissioner?
Well, you know, I have had over 30 years of wrestling experience, and I'd have every trick tried on me in the book. Right. And I've always been proud of my profession. It's been good to me and my family over the years. But what I've seen in the past few years, frankly, Mr. Cottle, I don't agree with. So when Smoky Mountain Wrestling Organization called me and said, would you like to be a commissioner, I thought, what a perfect opportunity to bring back to the people wrestling as it should be, as it used to be. I mean, wrestling affordable at family prices where the whole family can come and enjoy wrestling like it was invented. It's the oldest sport known to man, and it's going to be treated like a sport as long as I'm here. The fines will be not light but heavy. The fines will be heavy for any infraction of the rule. There will be no over-the-top rope. There'll be no foreign object. You will not touch a referee because there's a little man in there, a little referee that may weigh 150 pounds, getting pushed around by some big 290-pound guy. Well, I still wrestle sometime, Bob, and I can push around myself. So whatever needs to be done, Smoky Mountain Wrestling is going to do it. We want to be a part of your community. We want you to be a part of us. We want your cards and letters. Tell us what you want. I'm going to do my job as commissioner. I know it's not going to be easy. Don't get me wrong.
Well, they're going to test you.
Yeah, exactly. Yes, they'll test me, but I'm up to the test. Smoky Mountain Wrestling will be the best.
Fans, there you hear it from Commissioner Bob Armstrong. It's going to be great, Smoky Mountain Wrestling. You be sure to be with us.
This match is one fall with a 15-minute time limit. First off, weighing in at 221 pounds from St. Petersburg, Florida, here is Barry Horowitz. And his opponent, his opponent at 288 pounds from Orlando, Florida, Prime Time, Brian Lee.
All right, fans, our next match, Bad Boy Barry Horowitz, Prime Time, Brian Lee. And Dutch Mantell, you've been saying a lot. You really wanted to look at this youngster. I tell you, just look at Brian Lee, Prime Time, and he's in the prime of life. Look at that fantastic body, tremendous size, 288 pounds. He's 6 foot 6 inches tall.
Yes,
it's all muscle and strength and might.
Well, now that's what it looks like to the untrained eye. There, once again, Bob Collar, you're looking at this like a fan would look at it. I am a wrestling commentator. I am hired exclusively to come out here and tell people exactly what's going on in a wrestling match. Now, if you look at the bio, Brian Lee comes to us highly touted.
Absolutely.
A great wrestler with a great background, wrestled in Puerto Rico, Japan, Texas, and probably is one of the most underrated wrestlers in the profession today. But when he's going after Barry Horowitz, now let's look at their bio. Let's just look at their bio just a minute. Brian Lee played baseball and football at the University of Florida.
All-around great athlete. Yes, sir.
But also, with the same token, Barry Horowitz wrestled collegiately on a full-ride scholarship at Florida State University in Tallahassee, Florida. Now, you might say that that Brian Lee, you know, is a great athlete.
Yeah.
He is a great athlete. But see, he's in there with a wrestler right now, and I think see the move he's got right there.
Yeah, with the armbar. He had a leverage factor too, as he was standing up over him, and Horowitz was down on the mat. What you're really saying, I guess, Dutch, is that Horowitz has the experience factor, and that goes a long, long way. But when you're as big and you're as strong and you're as powerful as Prime Time Brian Lee is, good clothesline right there by Horowitz, though. Bad Boy Horowitz really took him down to the mat and took him down hard. But the big man has the strength and the stamina to take a lot of punishment and to keep coming back.
I understand, Bob, what you're saying. But Brian Lee is highly touted. But see, he's made some mistakes already that I wouldn't have made, a veteran wouldn't have made. Now, if he would have been a little more experienced and maybe just a little better wrestler, but he comes to us highly touted. But I wouldn't have made those mistakes like that.
Horowitz is showing you that he really has a lot of experience in that ring. He's put a lot of good moves already on Brian Lee with that leg drop as he got high in the air right down across the throat. Oh, I think he's got the big guy mad, though, right now. He came out of there, and he came up quickly with that big foot.
Well, now, what he's going to do now, he let his temper
right to the midsection.
He let his temper get the best of him right there, and as a result, he suffered for it. You know, Barry Horowitz is a pretty fair wrestler in his own right.
Horowitz has been around. He's taken on the best. He's got the bear hug now. Belly-to-belly suplex, and he took him down with that one. Hard to the mat.
Brian Lee, he's kicking out, but he's kicking out just, he needs to be kicking out just a little bit. See, I wouldn't have done that. I wouldn't have done that. He needs to kick out at one.
Look at that standing drop kick, and Horowitz got high in the air, and he exploded that drop kick right onto the chin of big Prime Time Brian Lee. Brings him out of the corner with that snap bear, and Horowitz has really been on the offensive.
Yes.
He has carried the match right to Brian Lee.
That's the experience factor taking over.
Now, Lee, again, showing you the strength and the stamina that he's got, and he's not afraid to stand toe-to-toe with you and to fight fire with fire, and that's what he's doing right there with Horowitz. Now back to the corner.
Well, they always say a good big man will always beat a
He may have him pinned right here. Count of two. Boy, what a good win that would have been for Barry Horowitz.
That's been a great win.
Where everybody could have seen it.
I've already decided I don't like Brian Lee. I just don't like him. I don't know what it is about him. I have a dislike for him. Uh-oh. Horowitz, he may have made a mistake then.
Well, Lee held onto the ropes. He wasn't home as Horowitz again went up for that drop kick, and he landed right on the base of that neck and onto the shoulders as he hit the mat and hit it hard. The whip all the way across the corner. Look at the high to the air. He went with that back toss.
Well, see, that's what we talk about, making mistakes. He let Brian Lee get back on the offensive, and now that might be Barry Horowitz's undoing.
Barry Swift on the clothesline as he comes off. Now it's Horowitz who's flat on the mat. Brian Lee now coming on strong. Looked like it took him just a few minutes here in the match to really figure Horowitz out. Now as Horowitz comes off of the ropes.
Well, he's got him up now in the backbreaker.
Well, what he calls a cancellation, and he just canceled a stamp of bad boy Barry Horowitz. 1-2-3. There's your winner, prime time Brian Lee fans, a young man.
Prime time Brian Lee.
A young man that you're going to see and hear a lot about, Brian Lee. And Dutch, I tell you, that's just simply fantastic. Let's watch it again.
Well, you call it the cancellation. Brian Lee, all 288 pounds of him, he got the former amateur wrestler from Florida State, and he drops him right across the spine right there, and that's all she wrote for Barry Horowitz here on Smoky Mountain Wrestling.
Fans, we'll be back with more right after we take this timeout. Fans, right now, let's take a moment to hear these words from legendary wrestling great, now a top manager, Ron Wright.
It certainly is nice to be here on Smoky Mountain Wrestling. I'd just like to tell everyone, you wonder why I'm sitting here in this wheelchair the way I am. My wrestling career for years, all of those men beating on me took a toll on me. Now I'm needing a hip implant and a knee implant, and I'm down here scouting, looking over all of these top wrestlers they have in this Smoky Mountain Wrestling area. I'm going to try to find some of the top wrestlers that I can maybe get in there and get me a contract with to where I can go out and make me some money and have this surgery that I'm needing. I'd like to just tell all of the wrestlers in this area, I'm one of the world's most famous, well-known wrestlers, and I'd like for all of them to get in there and show me what they've got, and I'm going to be looking at them, and one of these days here, I'm going to try to get someone up, get their name on a contract, and if I can get them on a contract with Ron Wright, I'll be able to have this surgery and take these men to the top in this Smoky Mountain wrestling empire. Everybody remember that, because that's what I'm here for.
And this match is one fall with a 15-minute time limit. First off, weighing in at 218 pounds, from Knoxville, Tennessee, Golden Boy, Joe Kazana. And his opponent.
The thunder rolls and the lightning strikes. Another love grows cold on a sleepless night. As the storm goes on.
At 222 pounds from Morristown, Tennessee, Wide Lightning, Tim Horner.
All right, fans, there you have it. And it's Golden Boy Joe Kazana, White Lightning, Tim Lightning, and White Lightning, Tim Horner. I had Lightning in there twice, didn't I, Dutch? But I was just going to say that this should be a very quick and exciting match because you've got two really quick guys in the ring right now. They both got a lot of speed. They got a lot of agility and a lot of quickness. It should really be a fast-paced match.
Well, Joe Kazanis grew up in a wrestling family in Knoxville, Tennessee. His grandfather was a former promoter there in Knoxville. Tim Horner, of course, he looks real very trim. He looks in shape. This will be a fast-paced match. But then again, sometimes the underdog may come up and win one because Joey Kazanis will not be favored in this match. Tim Horner has wrestled all over the world, and Kazanis is still trying to make a name for him here in professional wrestling, and he just may come up with the upset right here today. You know, I feel sorry for Ron Wright. Needs a hip operation.
I was going to say, you know, what about those words from him? You know, but I tell you, some poor old man, you know, he's one of the meanest, toughest wrestlers ever was Ron Wright.
Well, the reason he got in that shape was all those wrestlers took advantage of him, beat him up. He's really a kind man, real kind-hearted, gentle guy, and I sort of feel sorry for him. I really do.
Dutch, I don't know many fans that really felt that way about Ron Wright.
Well, I do.
Back to the corner now, and there you saw Horner. He really took a right hand, and that was an uppercut right under the chin from Kazana into the corner right over.
Ooh, good
Horner
move. Good move. Hip toss.
Top kick as he got high in the air again. That was right on the front. Arm drag, takedown again by Horner, and there's some of that speed and quickness we talked about.
Well, Horner looks very sharp today. He looks real sharp.
Well, he said he was born and raised in Morristown, Tennessee. He still
lives
there.
Well, that doesn't have nothing to do with his sharpness, being from Morristown, Tennessee. I don't. If anything, that's a detriment, being from Morristown, Tennessee. Now, don't get me wrong, not saying anything bad about the town, but being from Morristown, Tennessee, you know, if you told somebody up north you're from Morristown, Tennessee, they wouldn't know what you're talking about. And yes. Wouldn't care, by the way.
Here's Kazana now with a headlock. He brings Tim Horner off of the ropes with that headlock out near the center of the ring and with a wrist. Now, Horner almost had a reversal. Kazana, again, back with a headlock and into the ropes, and there is going to be the whip across the ring. Good takedown, leg takedown right there by Horner.
Well, I'm not taking anything away from Horner. He's giving young Mr. Kazanis a wrestling lesson right now.
Well, he's wrestled all over the world, Dutch. He's returned to his roots here in Smoky Mountain Wrestling. And really for some really tough competition without all of the show business and some of the other groups, the big groups you know of professional wrestling.
Oh, I understand what you're talking about. See, Tim Horner really is an ultimate wrestler. He trains hard. He wrestles hard. He stays in shape. And when he goes out there, he goes out with the attitude to win. But see, two objects, a law of physics says two objects cannot occupy the same space at the same time. So one man has to win, one man has to lose.
Yeah, you see those big letters right across the back of the tights there. Of
Golden
the
Boy.
Golden Boy. I tell you, they really stand out, don't they? There's Horner now into the corner across the rope. And Kazana, with all of his weight and his pressure right down across that throat, trying to cut the air off of Horner. And if you do that, Dutch, it doesn't take a long time. You can be sucking air in a hurry if that happens to you, can't you?
Well, to other guys, to me, see, I swam underwater one time for 10 minutes. You know, I set a record. I'm in the Guinness Book of World Records for holding my breath the longest underwater. Most guys, you cut the wind off, you beat them. But, you know, but I'm just a little bit different. I hate to say that and bring it out on this program today, but it is true.
Yeah, you're a little bit different, Dutch. You're right. Well, there was Horner. He got that knee right to the back again as Kazana got high to the air with it. And Kazana now has got him to the air under the shoulder. Power slam as he just drives Horner to the mat and drives him to the mat hard.
Could be all over.
Through the ropes. What's he going to do here, Dutch? Looks like he's going out to get to the top rope. There's Horner. He was waiting on him. Watch out. It's a long way to the mat.
Wow. That looked like that hurt, Bob.
That hurt, and that had to hurt. Not only looked like it, but had to. Hey, Dutch. Right here, let me just tell all of the fans, and something that I've been looking forward to, and I know you have too, we're going to see the debut of the Big Black Scorpion that's coming up in our next match.
The Big Black Scorpion
black
right here on
Scorpion.
Smoky Mountain Wrestling.
Yes, sir. Horner, whip to the ropes, comes right over Kazana. Held the rope that time.
Good
Kazana
move.
Face down
good
to the
move.
Mat. From behind.
Wait a minute, he's got him in his roll-up.
This he's is got the... him roll-up in the natural bridge right there.
Got him.
The roll-up in the...
And your winner is Wide Lightning, Tim Horner.
The roll-up in the natural bridge by Horner. And again, Dutch, let's watch it in slow motion.
Well, right here, Tim Horner making a debut appearance here on Smoky Mountain Wrestling. Does his signature move, the roll-up, and he sits right on top of Joey Kazanis. He gets the pin right here on Smoky Mountain Wrestling. There you see the referee counting 1, 2, 3. All you little munchkins, watch real close if you have any aspiration for being a professional wrestler. Right now, let's go to Bob Cottle and Jimmy Cornette.
All right, Dutch, and thank you. Fans right here with me, of course, the Louisville Slugger himself, Jim Cornette. I guess you got to say one of the premier managers in all of professional wrestling.
You know, I know what everybody out there in television land, I know what you're saying. Jim Cornette, you're an international star. You're a celebrity. Why are you in a nothing-happening, stinking place like Greenville, South Carolina? Well, there's a couple of reasons. First of all, I realize that it's not often you people in the backwoods, you hillbillies out in the sticks, get to see a celebrity. So today I was feeling charitable. But what's more, I heard that professional wrestling is coming back.
Yes, sir.
You see, over the past couple of years, these big corporations, these major promotions, they've turned it into a circus, into a sideshow. It's not whether you can wrestle anymore. It's whether you want to wear a funny costume. It's not whether you can fight. It's whether you can sell a doll over Toys R Us. It's not whether you've got guts. It's how juiced up on steroids you are. They've turned professional wrestling into a joke, so I turned my back on them because I made my reputation managing the greatest tag team in the history of wrestling, the Midnight Express. And they were a team that could wrestle and would fight and would let nobody stand in their way of getting to the top and winning a title. Nobody ever gave us anything. And we wouldn't turn around and do no favors. That's why they pushed us to the side. Well, brother, coming up in the weeks to come, I'm going to be bringing a dynamic tag team to Smoky Mountain Wrestling. A team that's going to revolutionize tag team wrestling just like the Midnight Express did. Because, brother, This is the real deal. Ain't no cartoon wrestling. And Jim Cornette is going to be the king of the hill.
Fans, that's something to look for from Jim Cornette. And we'll be back right after this.
This match is one fall with a 15-minute time limit. In the ring at 189 pounds from Columbus, Georgia, here is Paul Miller. And his opponents. From parts unknown, at 278 pounds, the Black Scorpion.
All right, fans, and this is a match that we've really been looking forward to. The Black Scorpion, 278 pounds, a big one, in against Paul Miller. And I tell you, he's really got the size advantage on Miller, Dutch. But, you know, the Scorpion's name has been on the lips of all the wrestling fans for about a year now. And we, as well as all wrestling fans everywhere, have heard a lot about him.
Yeah, you know, the Black Scorpion, nobody knows who he is, where he comes from. And right now, Paul Miller, where's he from?
He's from Columbus, Georgia.
Columbus, Georgia, land of high water and low brains. He's from a place, right now he's sort of got the Scorpion on the defensive, but that's not going to be for long. This Scorpion is a tough, tough man. Sometimes I wonder why they put guys like Paul Miller against guys like the Black Scorpion, because, you know, sometimes it ends up a total slaughter.
Well, I don't think it's going to happen with this young man. Dutch, you can see already that he's got a tremendous amount of wrestling moves. The way he gets around that ring, he's very quick and he's very agile. That's what he's got to do against a man with a side move. He scooped him up, drove him hard right to the mat.
Now, that was an excellent scoop slam.
Yes, sir.
By the Black Scorpion.
Scooped him right off of the mat, slammed him hard to it, came with the elbow, and he is really on the offensive now.
I wish maybe he'd do that to like a guy like Primetime Brian Lee or somebody. See if he could get up.
Well, it certainly appears that, and that when you look at it and what's going on in the ring, that Paul Miller is certainly overmatched here.
Well, sometimes
you
have to take your lumps if you're going to get anything in life. Nobody's going to come to you and hand you anything unless you're willing to work for it, and I mean work hard, then you're not going to attain anything in life. See, professional wrestling is no different from anything else. You have to work at it. You have to work at it very hard and very diligently to make anything happen, to make anything occur. This Black Scorpion, he's coming in here. He's got an opportunity to really, I mean, annihilate this Paul Miller, and he's doing a pretty decent job of it right now.
Well, he certainly has. As we said, got him overmatched and into the ropes now. He continues to just really work him over. He mauls him at every opportunity he gets, and he's had it throughout the match to the corner now with his right hand. Well, there's a reversal of the whip, and into the corner. Here goes Miller on top of him, into the corner now. But look at this, the power of the Scorpion. He just lifts him up and carries him off.
Well, I'm not going to describe that hole, but I can describe that one. He almost decapitated Paul Miller right there.
He almost took his head and handed it to him with that clothesline. That big, tremendous arm of his, and what a tremendous amount of power. The guy's got power all. Look at the muscles and all in that upper body. You know he's got
very powerful man.
Upper body power.
Reminds me a lot of myself.
High again to the air with that power slam as he just drove him hard to the mat. And Miller,
you see,
he appears to be almost out.
The Black Scorpion could pin him right now, I think, if he wanted to. But I think he's going to punish Paul Miller. He's going to punish this man for thinking he can step in a ring with him and compete with him.
Lifts him high to the air again. Another power slam. And again, hard to the mat goes Paul Miller.
See, the Scorpion's just toying with him right now.
Well, he is really taking a punishment. Miller has taken it. He's a game young man. You got to say that for him.
Well,
he's taking it, and he keeps coming.
I don't know how game he is. He's pretty tough.
Small package.
Wait a minute.
He caught the Scorpion looking the other way. He rolled him up.
He got him with that small package for the count of 1, 2, 3. Paul Miller in a surprise win right there, Dutch.
And here is Paul Miller.
What a tremendous comeback, and how quick it all reversed as Paul Miller in the small package put it on the Scorpion for the win. There he is, fans, your winner, Paul Miller, and we'll be back. We'll have more right after we take this time out. Fans, right now, a young man that has wrestled around the world and successfully, I might add, Primetime Brian Lee. And Brian, welcome to Smoky Mountain Wrestling.
Thank you, Bob. I just want to take a second of your time and these great people out here. I want to let you know in the near weeks to come, there's going to be a heavyweight tournament, and I plan to be in it, and I plan to win it, and I plan to wear the gold. All you great people behind me, I know I can do it.
Excuse me one minute. I know it's not my time, but, you know, I'm just going to give you some helpful advice. You know, when you was in the ring a while ago, I was watching real close, and you made some mistakes. Even though small and minor they may be, you know, when you, you let him clothesline you one time. See, that would have never happened to me. I wouldn't let him do that to me, see. And you had him in an arm bar one time. See, I'd have done that differently. You know, coming to think of it, I'd have wrestled that whole match differently. Now, if you learn to do that, you may be successful. Unless you do, I think you're just going to flounder around on the bottom. Now, I'd wrestle the whole match differently.
You're exactly right, Dutch. You would have wrestled it differently. You'd have lost the match. You may be a good wrestler, but you're not ready for prime time.
Hey, Dutch. There's your answer, no doubt about that. Fans,
you know,
look for this young man.
You, some people can't take constructive criticism.
A young man you're going to hear a lot of on Smoky Mountain Wrestling. We'll be back with our main event right after this.
Match is our television main event at one fall with a 30-minute time limit. First off, from Moscow, USSR, weighing in at 104 kilos, the Russian Bear, Ivan Koloff. And his opponent, gentlemen, is one half of the Fantastics, weighing in at 215 pounds from the City of the Angels, Bobby Fulton.
Fans, right now, let's hear what Ivan Koloff had to say about Bobby Fulton.
Smoky Mountain promotion. Ivan Koloff is very happy to be here. Not like you, Bobby Fulton. Fantastic. It is over for you. You made a big mistake to challenge Ivan Koloff. I'm going to embarrass you, humiliate you, pull, push, tug on whatever arm or leg I get a hold of you. I'm going to make you suffer.
All right, that's what he thinks of Bobby Fulton, fans. And, Dutch, this should be a good match. Fulton, of course, has got to use his quickness, also his experience. He's a well-experienced young man in the ring. He's got a lot of agility, but you talk about experience, Ivan Koloff is one that's got it all. A Russian Bear has been up against the very best champions all around the world. He's a real veteran of the ring, and he's as rough and tough as they get in that squared circle.
Ivan Koloff, the best and most widely known Russian wrestler ever in the United States, and experience. He has tons of experience over Bobby Fulton. And when you pit experience against youth sometimes, you know, the youth doesn't come out on top. Old age and treachery will beat youth and ability anytime.
Especially that treachery, I guess.
You know, I can't get over the way Brian Lee talked to me out here. I don't,
the way he talked to you.
Right.
Dutch, I thought it was just the other way around. You was telling him what all he had done wrong,
I
how
was
you would
giving,
have done it different, what you, how you would have won that match.
I was giving him helpful hints, and he took it wrong. See, that's... I don't know. He's got a bad attitude. You know, next week I'm going to wrestle right here on this program, and I want Brian Lee to be watching because I'm going to show him how it's really done. I'm going to make my debut here on Smoky Mountain Wrestling next week.
Oh, boy. Hey, I'm glad to know that, Dutch. I'm going to look forward to seeing you here right here next weekend, fans. And Dutch, don't forget, you promised that, and you promised all the fans that you'll be right here. Koloff now with a wrist and Fulton. Fulton is really best known as one half of the Fantastics, and with his brother Jackie, they've held tag team titles all over the world. That's a tremendously popular tag team.
But by the same token, Ivan Koloff has also won major titles all over the world. Hey, he beat Bruno Sammartino at Madison Square Garden and became the WWF champion. Let's not forget that. So when we're talking about champions, let's throw a little bit on Ivan's side out there, that he was a champion also in his own right.
Well, that happened, of course, in Madison Square Garden back in 1971. So he's a real veteran. He's been tested. As you say, and we said earlier, he's taken on the best all around the world. And not only that, he's bested the best many, many times. And I tell you, he recently brought his brother or his nephew, Ivan's nephew Vladimir, to the USA, and I can anticipate that we might see them in some tag team action. Hey, wait a minute, Dutch. Look who's down there at ringside. Do you see him? There he is.
There's
Ron Wright.
There's Mr. Wright.
Yes, sir. Ron Wright sitting there in that wheelchair looking at the action in the ring.
He's scouting.
You think that's what he's doing?
He's scouting these two? See, the man, he needs money. He needs a hip operation and a knee operation, and he said he's looking for men to manage, and he's down there, and he's looking now. At this point, it's not clear. Is he looking at Bobby Fulton to manage?
I was going to ask you that. Do you think he's scouting Fulton, or do you think he's scouting Koloff?
Well, I don't know. I could run down there and ask him, but I think he's in his own world right now. He's scouting, and you know how... There he is. He's watching that match very intently.
Yeah, I was going to say, he's got an intense look in his eye as he's looking up at the action in the
ring. I really feel for Mr. Wright. You know, he was a legend. He was a legend wrestler, and he was a legend being just a manager. And now he's come upon hard times. And, you know, a lot of people, they don't feel compassion for their fellow man like I do. You know, I feel for the homeless, and I feel for the underprivileged and the handicapped and all that. And I feel bad for Mr. Wright.
Well, the size and the weight right now of Ivan Koloff seems to begin to take a toll on Bobby Fulton.
You know, sometimes in these matches, it's heart that wins.
Ooh. Beautiful dropkick. Nobody can stand up to that. He's got a kick of a mule when he gets high in the air with that dropkick.
He came off the mat. He came out of left field with that one.
As the ears of Koloff. He sends him flying halfway across the ring just by the ears as he came off of the rope. I don't think Wright was too impressed with that. You could almost see him shaking his head no to that one. But now here is Fulton again with a headlock.
There, good move.
Yes, sir.
Good move by Ivan Koloff. A back suplex on Bobby Fulton and takes him down. Now, that takes the wind out of you right there.
Well, it does, and Fulton had him in a headlock, and all Ivan did, reached down, got him up in the air with that back suplex, and Fulton hit the mat, and he hit it hard. But here's an experience factor. Look how quickly Ivan Koloff is back on the attack as he's right on top of Fulton.
See, he went to drop a leg on Bobby Fulton, and Bobby moved.
Ducked under that one. Flying press, can he hold him?
But he didn't get him.
On the count of two.
He didn't get him.
Only goes left hands, those jabs right in. That right hand sends Koloff right through the ropes. Off of the apron now, down on the floor, and it looked like Fulton was going to go through the ropes down after him. They're down onto the floor now, and they're slugging it out outside of the ring right here. Wait a minute. Here's Ron Wright over. What was he doing? Shaking a hand of who? Koloff or...
Well, he went to
Fulton.
Shake the hand of Bobby Fulton.
Yeah, looked like he was going to shake Fulton's hand.
And Bobby just ignored it.
Now, here is Koloff just driving him. Look, he hit that ring post with a full head of steam as Koloff slammed him to the post and slammed him hard. Now, into the chair out near the ringside. And Koloff now looks like he's got the head. He got that chair in the air, driving into the head of Fulton. Holding Fulton over that fence that's around the ring to separate the ring.
That's called a barricade, Bob.
All right, a barricade to separate the crowd from the ring, Dutch. It's metal, whatever it is.
Yes,
it's
it is. And it hurts. Fence. It hurts very badly.
Back into the ring. Here's Koloff just stomping away now, Fulton. He is really mauling him right now, Dutch.
Well, he's taking advantage. He went outside the ring. Neckbreaker. Now, I think it was bad on Bobby Fulton's part. Here you got a man sitting outside in a wheelchair that can't move, and Bobby Fulton's trying to jump out over the top of him to get to Ivan Koloff. I'm just glad they didn't hurt Mr. Ryder.
Well, here is Fulton now with right hands and drives Koloff to the ground. Koloff break over the second rope, and he is now out here. And now there is Wright, is over to shake the hand of Koloff.
Shaking his hand, a good sportsman-like gesture.
And Koloff with a right hand, he just about turned, he did. He turned the lights out. He turned Fulton's lights out with that right hand. Did Wright give him something outside of the ring?
The winner of the match is Ivan Koloff.
Here comes Jackie Fulton in, and Jackie now complaining to the referee. Koloff is saying no.
Now, what's he complaining about?
Well, Jackie, I think, is saying here is he and Koloff now slugging it out.
Now, this is not right. That's not fair. Jackie Fulton is not a very sportsman-like man coming in the ring like that. In fact, Ivan Koloff had just wrestled for 10 minutes.
Wait a minute, right here. There's an object. He did give Koloff something. And the referee's going to reverse that decision, it looks to me like, as he's over now. Here comes Vladimir. We got the Russians.
Well, that's good.
Fantastic.
That's good.
Four of them in the ring.
Well,
look at the chaos right now.
That turnabout's fair play. Did he reverse that decision?
Was that accidental by Wright or not? When he reached up the hand or to shake the hand of Ivan Koloff. Now, here's Jackie Fulton being choked. Ivan Koloff has got the chain.
Is that Vladimir the nephew?
That's the nephew. That's Vladimir. He's a big one, too.
Oh, he is a big one, isn't he?
Over the top rope now. And Bobby Fulton is being hung right there over that top rope. Or is that Jackie? That's Jackie.
Now Bobby's up.
Yeah, here's Bobby Fulton now from behind on Koloff as Jackie was just being choked and hung right over the top rope by the Koloff. Fans, what a way to end, and what a wild time it was. There's all chaos broke loose, and the hand right now being raised. Now Bobby Fulton is the winner. We'll be back. Let's take time out for this. Fans, what a wild, chaotic finish to that match here. The Fantastics and Commissioner right here, Bob Armstrong.
Let me interrupt right here. You know, I told you that foreign objects will not be tolerated. Right here it is, right here on this paper. That's a rule.
Yeah.
Ivan Koloff, you're going to be fined $500.
Wow.
And as a matter of fact, while we're talking about Koloff, if they want to fight each other's battles, we can settle that. I tell you what, I'll sign a match next week right here on TV, and we'll put both the Koloffs against the Fantastics. How about that?
All right. What about that, Bob? What about that?
Hey, yeah, I'm going to go sign it right now, boy.
Thank you, Bob. Hey, listen, let me tell you, a lot of things are happening around here. I couldn't agree with Jim Cornette more. They're bringing it back to wrestling what it's about the way the fans like it. Now, Koloff, I've been hit with fists before in the past and by yours. And I don't know who that goof was in the wheelchair, Bob.
Right.
But he handed something to Ivan Koloff. My brother seen it. Hey, we just want law and order. Like Bob, the commissioner, said, Armstrong, right? He's going to sign this match next week as a main event. Well, let me tell you, ball-headed commie geek, something right now. This is Smoky Mountain Wrestling. Things like that aren't going to happen. We're going to fight fire with fire. Hey, Bob, they jacked my jaw, and I'll tell you, they tried to publicly hang my brother right on TV. We thought about a fresh wrestling start. Well, we see that when the Koloffs are around, things are going to start a little different, and it's their way. Hey, like I said, we're ready to fight fire with fire, and as long as those great people of the United States get behind us, we know that we're going to do one thing. That's kick tail, just like we did overseas against Saddam Hussein and those characters. We're going to do it with Ivan Koloff and that no good other nasty ball-headed Koloff. And let me tell you something, Ron Wright. That's his name, right? The guy in the wheelchair.
Right. That's right.
You may be crippled and you may be an old man, but brother, next time you interfere in my match, I'm going to pick you up out of that wheelchair myself and I'm going to kick you straight in the booty, because regardless, you shouldn't have got in the ring. You shouldn't even been ringside. And hey, Bob, like I said, this is far from over. Next week, the fans are going to see it on TV. No more publicly hangings. Hey, I'll tell you, I can't wait.
See you next week, fans. And until then, that's our main event.
Right.
So long for now.
Hey,